Smudge Katazili is one of the most underrated defensive heroes in the game right now, and here is why. By default, Smudge Cut has camo detection, which allows it to counter Jericho's early camo AI really easily. Its level 3 ability, Screech, pops all the purple balloons on the map and strips the regrow property from all the balloons on the screen. Its level 7 ability gives a totem, which gives camo detection, extra pierce, attack speed, range, and projectile speed to nearby monkeys, and only costs 5 lives to do so. Smudge Cut's level 8 ability also gives it even more mob class damage, so when you have Smudge Cut on the map, it actually just kind of invalidates all mob class rushes. It solos mobs really easily. And also, level 10 Smudge Katazili is really strong as well, where it places curses on 3 of the strongest mob class balloons, and if you pop the mob class balloon when the curse is on it, no children are spawned. Because of that, you will see me use Smudge Katazili today along with a lot of other heroes and loadouts, because this is Sweat Series Episode 13, which is a series where I use all of the best strategies in Blue and Sea Battles 2 to teach you guys the best way to win. So let's hop right into the first match. Let's get it, guys. And also, if you guys have been enjoying the Sweat Series as much as I've been enjoying making it, please go to the creator support tab in your shop and put in code Ryan Mihalik. It takes 5 seconds and it can really help me out, but let's hop right into the video. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are now on episode 13 of the Sweat Series, and we're against Ertos here on the map of what is the map even called, Banana Depot, with the strategy Bomb Submarine Farm and Highwayman Jericho. Now they brought Smudge Katazili, which I think is really interesting here. Smudge Katazili, certainly an odd pick on this map, but we're gonna have to see what they cook with. Okay, they start with their Smudge Cut and their Bomb Shooter. Honestly, I'm expecting some sort of wizard loadout. I've seen people trying the wizard bug with Smudge Katazili a lot. Going like wizard village and bomb is one popular loadout. So honestly, that's kind of what I think Ertos may be bringing here, wizard village bomb. But we'll have to wait and see. And they'll be using like the Phoenix Glitch late game to defend is most likely what's gonna be happening here. Let's get my Howman Jericho down. So I might have to be kind of aggressive to them to be able to counter that loadout here. Might be the game plan. Okay, we're gonna balloon boost some yellows. We're gonna boost against their yellows. Force some leakage on their side. Okay, they got their cluster bomb up. Nicely done. Let's get my cluster bomb up. Alright, everything's good here. Everything's good. Everything's good off the start. And then we'll continue ecoing alongside as per usual. But yeah, I'm currently expecting Wizard Village Farm. Wizard Village Bomb is my current expectation of a loadout from them with Smudge Katazili, because that is a loadout I have seen kind of jumping around Hole Masters here and there, and it's a pretty good loadout too. I haven't tried it on my channel yet, but definitely was planning on trying it out at some point here. All right, we're gonna move this obstacle, start saving for my first farm here. We're down to 69 lives, but that's totally fine. They actually moved an obstacle as well. Maybe they don't have that strategy, because maybe they don't have Wizard Village Bomb, because why would they move that obstacle if they have an eco loadout? Yeah, I don't think they have eco here. Never mind, I was wrong. I was wrong. This is on last, right? Yeah. We just tank the leaks on this balloon boost. We're good. Don't leak that much there. The bomb is so strong on this map. They get their first farm a little bit before me, but that's totally fine because I'll have steals coming in. So it might be bomb sub farm versus bomb sub farm in all honesty, which would be interesting. Now we obviously have the different hero choices here. We have Highwayman Jericho, they have Smudge Cut Azita. I feel like Highwayman's better with bomb sub farm here. Smudge Cut obviously will offer them a little bit of defensive support, like especially against mob class balloons. Smudge Cut has a lot of mob damage, but I don't know. I think Highwayman's definitely the better hero choice with bomb sub farm here. I guess it might be like bomb wizard farm. There's also a possibility it's something else as their third, but I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. We'll have to wait and see. We'll just keep ecoing for the time being though. Just keep building up my economy. Our second steal will come around like round 11-ish. So we'll use that then. Maybe get a plantation early. They send me zebras. Okay, they're sending me some region white balloons. Let's actually get heavy bombs here. That's fine. That's our third balloon boost, I think, if I remember correctly. So they've been balloon boosting. Send them a couple zebras. Oh wait, they actually got their heavy bombs straight up as well. Okay, we both got our heavy bombs up then. All is good. All is good. Okay, pretty soon here, I'm gonna get up my plantation. One more eco boost. Yep, there's their sub. So it is bomb sub farm for my opponent. As I expected. Okay, we forced farm cell for their submerge. That's perfect. They're almost dead. I did not need to sell farm there. Why did I sell farm? That was really dumb. Okay, that was really dumb of me. I thought he was gonna ult out me, to be honest. I really thought he was gonna ult out me. That's why I sold a farm initially, but in hindsight, that was really bad. Okay, we forced the reactor. Yeah, I had enough money for my cluster bomb without selling a farm there, was the thing. And I just sold my farm kind of reactively, I don't know. I felt like they're gonna ult out me for some reason. We're in a fine position still, even selling the farm. We're still in a fine position here. It's just, that was definitely not the smartest play on my end. Definitely not the best play. Yeah, I had enough money for that second cluster without selling the farm. Okay. We have a farm advantage on them. We're up in eco. The only thing is I can't really rush them with Moabs because they've got Smudge Kazili, so even though they don't have any farms, I'm not really going to be able to pressure them because of it. If they send me Moabs or whatever, I can get up a Ballistic. Okay, we're good. Honestly, I should have went for a Mauler over a Ballistic. I don't know why I necessarily went for a Ballistic. A Mauler is kind of a better option, but it's fine. See if they rush me anymore. So far, it doesn't look like it. Alright, we'll just keep ecoing. Interesting game so far, interesting game. Definitely through on round 11, but we're still, I think, in a winning position here. Opponent's saving up a lot of money right now. They haven't built up farms or anything in a bit. Opponent's just sitting on money. Yeah, they go for a marketplace there, that's fine. They go for a second farm. They go for a big bombs in the back. Okay. 1250 eco. I think I'm gonna stop right there, just because I know I have a big eco lead on my opponent, so I don't really want to risk it by going for more eco. Don't really want to take many risks here. They're sending me a BFB. I don't even know if that's fortified or not. I don't know these Moab skins is the thing. We'll boost this. Yeah, I don't really know very much about the Moab skins. Is he gonna ult out me? I have the Moab the misdirection now, which is great. Doesn't look like they're gonna ult out me currently. That's fine. We'll take our out money. We're going to like 1350 eco. Central market. I feel like they're gonna send me all out DTs in round 26 is what they're gonna do here. It's kind of the feeling I'm getting right now. How much do you sell for? 20k. So I get 40k. Wait. These sell for 20k, right? Or 19k. And then I get another, that's like 20k in total. I'm close to affording. Very close. I think I can afford, to be honest. Yeah, we afforded. We afforded it. Okay, so what happens now is the question of the day. There's no way they can afford theirs, but I can't really send them DTs is the thing. I think we just let the game kind of drag on now. I didn't obviously need a balloon crush against a couple DTs, but the thing is, if I went for Mob Assassins, they would have just kept sending me non-stop DTs, and then I wouldn't have had to have money for my balloon crush. And if I just messed up my Assassin Micro, I'd die there. So getting up the balloon crush there is, I think, the safe play, and I think it's the right play. Yeah, we're good against that. They just send me a little pressure rush. All right. There's no way they afford their balloon crush, right? There's no way they can afford a balloon crush for round 30. So all I do is on round 30 is I send them some ZMGs. Well, maybe they can afford balloon crush. I don't know. I could send them a BAD round 30. I've got more eco than them 100%. This is a really interesting game. Both of us got so poor from that round 13 interaction where I sold my farms and stuff. Both of us got super poor from that. Yeah, send them those. They're trying to defend it without Balloon Crush here. I can send DTs behind, though, is the thing. I think they're dead against the DTs. It was a nice try. It was a nice try. Nice effort, but, alright, I'll take it. I'll catch you guys next game. That was a really interesting game, I'll be honest. That was one of the matches of all time. Alright, our next match of the video, guys, is against my man Smiley the Foot on the map of Salmon Ladder with our classic strategy of Boat, Alchemist, and Spike Factory. So we're gonna start with our boat right about here. Perfect. They're going boat as well, and they brought Benjamin as well, so it actually might be our mirror matchup here, which would be really interesting if we're both going the same exact loadout on this map. Just gonna be the better person with the loadout who wins, so yeah, we'll have to wait and see, but I'm gonna get my Benjamin round one here. They're actually sending me max red blue Nico, which leads me to believe they probably aren't gonna go for round one Benjamin. Yeah, they're going for grapes on their boat, so they're probably gonna get like round two Ben then. Interesting. Let's get my Benjamin down. Perfect. Micro the boat targeting a little bit. Trying to minimize the leaks here is gonna be important, and then we're gonna get my grape shot up pretty soon as well. Grape shot, nice. And then we want to get long range on this too. Long range. All right, perfect. Just trying to not leak very much at all early game. So they definitely get more eco with the way they started than me, but I get the round one Benjamin, which means I'm gonna get more money for my Benjamin overall. So there's definitely an argument to be made for both routes of the Benjamin play there. Definitely is an argument to be made for both routes there. We actually have a life advantage on them too, which is pretty nice. If I keep layering these blues and yellows, it should force a little bit of leaks on their end because they didn't go for a second boat. So we're going to do that. Be a little bit aggressive with our eco. Yeah, they're leaking a lot there. They went for hot shot. We're actually going to balloon boost pinks. They might die against this. They tower boost. Oh, they actually get their cannon ship up though right away. Nicely done. They afforded their cannon ship early. But yeah, they're down to 24, which is not very good for them. 24 lives is not too many there. We'll get our cannon ship up on round 5. I definitely like my start better. We traded a balloon boost for a boost, but I'm up on lives on top of that, and we've got a much higher life count, so. Wait, I just said life. I'm up on lives twice. Alright, we got our cantrip up as well. We'll probably both get a round 6 merchant man here, my guess will be. It's most likely what will happen. Okay, my cantrip is actually like not hitting any of the balloons on last. What the heck? It was like full missing the balloons. That was kind of scary. Theirs is on last and it's hitting all the balloons, so I don't really know. Maybe our placements are a little bit different. Or maybe my cannon ship was just like bad timing with its shots. I'm gonna keep it on first, I guess, then. I kind of would like to have it on last. How's this doing now? Okay, it seems like it's actually doing a little bit better on last now. Alright. The reason why I want it on last is because this cannon pretty much always fires into this like corner, which makes it pretty effective overall. Alright, we both got our merchants up. Nice. Send them some yellows. They need to be careful. They need to get their spike factory up. Okay. Are they good? They might die. I think they're dead. They tower boost? Okay, so they're down 2 tower boosts and down on lives. This is great. I'm gonna get my spike factory down. Long reach. Smart spikes. Smart targeting. We're in a really good spot here. Fantastic spot, actually. And then we'll get long life into bigger stacks as well here. Benjamin ability as well. Alright, that's good. Let's get my alchemist down right here. All is well. Stronger acid on this. Alright. We're up 2 boosts right now. We're up 2 boosts. I gotta keep remembering that. Up 2 boosts is really good here. Larger potions. Let's get my balloon bot down. Right there. Alright, our rubber to gold's gonna go right here. Will be the plan there. Yeah, they use Benjamin ability again. I probably should have done the same. I kind of forgot to use it. I'll be honest. I low-key forgot to use it there. They actually went for an Alk buff already. Interesting. I normally don't just pre-buy Alk buff on this map, to be honest. Okay, we used our thing there. And then when the round starts, I'll get my rubber to gold up. They're in there, that to gold up as well. Nicely done. Alright, we're gonna get rubber to gold here in a second. Perfect. And now we'll just max eco it. I think I'm in a much better position than them here. We've played, our early game was much cleaner. We're up two boosts. We have less defense on the map than them. They have a Berserkaroo, we don't. I'm probably up on Eco. Let's get a Acidic Mixture Dip on this, just to have it up. Because why not? And we'll just keep max Ecoing at them. I won't need that Berserker Brew for a while here. Probably get that up like round 19 when the ceramics come out of the AI path is when I'll actually need to buy it. But until then, we'll just keep greeting with my Eco and whatnot. Hopefully, I kind of want to get a second Rubber to Gold as well eventually, because one Rubber to Gold is not going to make enough money from their AI balloons. So I can get a second one. They actually use Benjamin ability there. I'm not going to use Benjamin ability because it's going to put my Rubber to Gold on downtime. Well, maybe I should have used it. I could have. It wouldn't have been terrible. What I can do, though, is if I get another Alchemist right here, when I use Benjamin ability, it's not going to put my Bolt on downtime, which is important. It'll put these four things on downtime, so next round, I'll use mine, and it should be quite effective. You'll see what I'm talking about in a second. So if I use it, it doesn't affect my Bolt, which is what I want. So then the Bolt will still keep my Spike Pile decently healthy. It's gonna lead to gold up. And we'll get that second Rubber to Gold up pretty soon here. I want to make sure they're desynced as well, the Rubber to Golds. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wait till this one throws. And now I'm gonna upgrade this one. So they're affecting different balloons, basically. I timed them so their throws are at different times. Also, I should not be sending them... Yeah, Zebra Balloons are probably not the smartest. Well, I can send Zebra Balloons when the Rubber Gold's not throwing. So, if I can time them well, when the Rubber Gold's not throwing, I can send a little bit of Zebra Balloon Eco, and the Rubber Gold won't really hit it. I won't do it too much, though. We got some Ceramics coming out. Let's get the Berserker Brew up. Let's get favorite trades on my end as well. Alright, all is good. Right now they're actually kind of hitting the same balloons again. I don't know how they got synced back up. It's a little bit unfortunate. I might go for a third Rubber to Gold to be honest here. Yeah, third Rubber to Gold's good. We'll keep Bolt farming here. Oh, this is good. Their Spike Pile is actually taking a beating, it looks like. Oh, let's get the Crow's Nest on my end. Spike Pile is almost dead. They're dead. What? Never mind. I'm wrong. I thought they were dead. It looked like it. I guess I'm wrong. Desync. Desync be like that sometimes, I guess. Use Ben ability. They stopped sending Eco for a second. Yeah, they got their Trade Empire up. Nicely done. I'm gonna get my Trade Empire up before this round ends, hopefully. Yeah, they're sending me that. Wait for it. Oh, they're dead! No way they die against AI like that. I was about to do some crazy tech to defend that ZOMG, guys. It would have actually been crazy. I was going to use Smart Spike, Spike Storm with a boost and bin level 3, and it would have just shredded it at the start of the round, at the start of round 24. I was about to show you guys a crazy ZOMG defense, but they died against AI, bro. I guess I'll catch you guys in the next game. All right, guys, we're on Banana Depot once again. I really want to try this strategy, to be honest. The Bomb Wizard Village strategy I was talking about on the first match. So we're going to start with our Bomb Shoot here. We're against Blue and Phoenix, who's starting with their TAC. They brought Star Captain Jericho as well. So maybe TAC Farm Mortar, probably, from my opponent. But we're going to send Group Blues, Group Reds on round one, because we're going an Eco loadout here. And yeah, we're going to see how it goes. I do think the strategy might be met on some maps. I have seen it used a little bit, and it's quite effective overall. So I wanted to take a shot at it in Sweat Series, because this could be a Sweat strategy, guys. It could be a Sweat strategy, even though it looks really weird. With the busted Phoenix right now, and Balloon Crush to clean up insides, it has some pretty good synergy. Plus, it's got a good early game with Bomb Shooter, so you don't have to really worry about building up Necromancer and all the purple balloon issues early game with Wizard, because you've got the Bomb start here. So it's got some decent aspects to it for sure. Alright, they're sending me yellows. I'm just gonna get up my cluster bombs here. There we go. Cluster bomb. Perfect. This one's strong as well, right? Yeah. We're good. Now, how's my plan early game? What's my plan looking like? Well, we should send blue balloons first of all. Cluster bomb start, obviously. Cluster bomb will be good for round 11, round 13. Camo detection, I could go for a camo village, or I could go for a shimmer. Shimmer's cheaper and takes up less space, so I think we'll do shimmer probably like right around here. For camo detection. And honestly, I could cross path the shimmer with like a wall of fire, and that might defend like ceramics for us. I'm not sure. We could try like a wall of fire shimmer to help us out against space ceramics round 13. Might be a decent plan of attack. That might be a plan. In the meantime, we'll just keep on Max Eco in here, though. This is on strong, right? Do we even want this on strong, to be honest? It's kind of... Yeah, I think it might be better on first, to be honest. You might be wondering why. When it was on strong, it was kind of popping a lot of these pink white balloons down early. And the pink balloons were kind of sneaking by my bomb shooter a little bit. So, I obviously don't want to be leaking here. So, I think maybe keeping you on first might allow that to not happen with my targeting and whatnot. We'll send in black balloons this round. And then we'll send yellows on round 7. And I fit a second... Okay. So, we'll get the shimmer here. I'm just trying to plan how I want my defense set up. I can get a second bomb here as well. Because if he sends me a big rush, I want to be able to fit a second bomb. Right? Because one cluster bomb will defend rushes on boost, but it won't defend re-rushes. I'll need a second bomb shooter for that. So I could honestly just... I gotta move this obstacle and just place a second bomb there. Would be the plan. If they send me like a re-rush with balloons. And I'll also have Smudge Cat Azili Totem by that point in the game too. So that'll be nice. Alright, I think I've got a decent idea of how this is going to play out. They got their mortar down, so they're chilling in their end. I'm just going to keep on max ecoing it. This should be on camo... Oh, I just used Smudge Cat by accident. This should be on camo priority targeting, though. I didn't mean to use Smudge Cat ability there. I was just trying to target it to camo priority. They got their Burnie stuff up. They honestly did not need a Burnie stuff against those balloons, but... I don't know. A little bit of an overreaction, I'd say. Zebra balloons, we're going to get heavy bombs on our side. Yeah, Shimmer is going to go right here. $1,600. Okay, so that's actually not that expensive, to be honest. The other upgrades are cheap before it, too, so. Let's get Shimmer up. And then, yeah, I was saying this will be a Wall of Fire for round 13. I don't know if that's a good idea to make it a Wall of Fire or not. I don't even know if that will defend Ceramics or not. I'm kind of just experimenting here with it, but... I feel like it might kind of work. I might be cooking. Wall fire. Alright, how's this defense looking here? We've got a really good eco too. That's the one thing I'm actually surprised about. Our eco is almost 1,000 on Banana Depot, which... This isn't a map that's really known for having good eco on. My opponent's farms are also kind of garbage. I just noticed that too. They don't even have a third tier farm on their side yet. Okay, they just got the marketplace up. Okay, we have the totem available now, which is nice. They're stealing from me. We're good against that. Oh, are we? Okay, a little close for comfort. We're fine, though. Let's actually target the totem right there. Get a second bomb down right there. And I could upgrade this to Necromancer. The thing about this Shimmer spot, though, is it's a horrible Necro spot. I feel like Necro wouldn't really do anything for me here. So I feel like just going for bomb defense is the better play if they do send me some sort of rush. They sold their tack. Okay. The good thing about Smudge Cat Azili too is it does a ton of mob class damage starting at level 8, so I'm not really too scared of mob layers. Smudge Azili should solo most mob layers by its own, and I just have to worry about the insides. Just preparing some bombs in the back here. Okay, we're good, we're good. At the moment. Yeah, we got level 8 Smudge now. Still no rush from them, mob class. I can also use Totem, which helps out the Azili a ton as well. If they don't send me any rushes, I do want to start saving up for an increased Eco Village, of course. Is going to be the plan there. Alright, they're just farming on, that's fine. Let's get my village down right here. 2,000 Eco is pretty solid for this map. Right now. Let's use Totem. I don't want to take chances against AI right now. The Totem comes back really quickly on Smudge Azili 2. Look how fast it popped down that mob, by the way. Because part of the totem was being used there. It hasn't... Oh, crap. Now that I don't have totem, though, this moab's actually a little bit of a problem, isn't it? With the AI balloons alongside. I think Smudge Azili still solos the moab, yeah. Smudge Azili actually still solos the moab pretty easily. Because Smudge Azili is OP. Yeah, we're good against that. Oh, they're IMF loaning. Are they going to IMF Lone rush me? They might. What's the plan against an IMF Lone big rush? Probably just buy a bunch of Maulers. And I have Azili. I'll have Azili level 10 as well. Yeah, they're going to IMF Lone rush me. Okay. Let's wait for the right moment. Come on, pop the ZMG. Pop the ZMG down. Please die. Please die. Yes, yes, yes. We sacrificed it. Come on, come on, come on. Bomb. We're good. Wizard. Wizard, I need decamo. We're good. Oh my gosh, I almost died there. Almost died. I had a glitch where it wouldn't let me place towers for a second there. That got a little scary, I'm not gonna lie. But the ZZ level 10 ability came in clutch for me there. We got the win. That's good. I'll catch you guys in the next game. Alright, our next match here, we're back on Salmon Ladder. Same loadout as before, but we're facing a different loadout for sure because they brought Churchill here. So we're gonna have to prepare for that. It might be Bomb Sub Farm Churchill, which honestly, I think that's the most popular loadout on this map. I've been seeing a lot of people going it recently. So I'm gonna prepare to face that. But yeah, target our boat a little bit round one. Just try to minimize leaks and then we'll get my my Benjamin down two. Perfect. Bin Hameen has been placed and should be pretty good for us. Now we'll just start saving up for that grape shot here. That grape shot, ladies and gentlemen. The grape shot Ahada. All right, grape shot has been bought. Nice. I actually don't need long range early here because they're not sending me any green balloons. So I don't need to buy this long range upgrade for a little bit. We can kind of hold off on that. Let's target a little bit. Now we'll get long range. All right, everything's good. A little bit of boat targeting. And we'll just continue maximizing our eco. Now, this matchup's definitely an interesting one. I have played it a couple times, and pretty much every time you play this matchup, what your opponent's gonna do is they're just pretty much gonna AFK until AFK and farm as hard as possible until round 30, and then send you infinite ZMGs. And it's a pretty good tactic, guys. It's really hard to defend infinite ZMGs with strategy. Even with supermines and some good BMA micro, you can get overrun. So my goal here is going to be to farm as hard as possible, eco as hard as possible, to afford a lot of BMAs I can micro in the late game and afford my supermines. But I also want to send them a little bit of pressure, not too much pressure, just a little bit of pressure, some efficient rushes to force a little bit of defense in there and slow down their farms with it as well. So that is how we are going to play this matchup here. We got our two boats down though. We're going to crow's nest on the second one as well. And then, oh wait, I accidentally upgraded my second boat to crow's nest. I was not thinking for a second there. This is actually kind of bad now. I can't afford my cannon ship yet because I upgraded my second boat when I didn't need to. Come on, cannon ship. I kind of put myself in a bit of a pickle there, huh? Yeah, we're good. You don't want to upgrade crow's nest on your second boat till you have the cannon ship up, guys. That was a mistake on my end. It's all good though. Big mistake. And we'll get merchantmen here pretty soon as well. Yeah, they're going for two subs on their side. That's fine. I think I get two more eco boosts this round, so I can still keep ecoing and get my merchantman up. Yeah, I get one more eco boost here. They get their second farm down, nicely done. Merchant has been bought. Perfect. Alright, start sending some black balloons with yells layered over. Does this do anything? Or do their subs kind of snipe the black balloons pretty easily? Seems like right now their subs are kind of doing their job. We actually forced a third sub on their side though, so I'll take it. I'll take that. A little bit of defense forced. Nothing crazy, of course, but we got them to get up a little bit more defense. Okay, we're gonna get my spike factory down right here. Just keep being greedy. Long reach on this. We'll get smart spikes here pretty soon as well. And then we'll send them zebra boons in the next round. Smart spikes, smart targeting. Zebra balloons at them. And then this will be a long life with bigger stacks is gonna be the plan there. Long life spikes. They use Churchill ability, that's fine. That means they don't have Churchill ability available for round 11 though. So I might be able to pressure them a little bit here. I forgot to use my ability there with Benjamin. We'll use it in round 11. Crap, I didn't mean to send leads there. They have to boost. Yep, that's good. They won't have boost available for round 13 now. That's exactly what we want. They do not have boost for round 13 now. So I should be able to force a cluster bomb pretty easily on their end with that reactor. All right, let's re-rush them. There we go, perfect. They actually overreacted like crazy. They sold two farms there. That's really good for me. I'm in a fantastic spot now, I'd like to say. That was a big overreaction from my opponent. That's exactly what I was talking about, guys, when I was saying small pressure rushes forcing to force defense. I didn't spend very much money on any of those rushes, and I got a lot out of it. Obviously, my opponent did overreact, and I don't think they defended them very well, but still got good value, nonetheless. All right, now we're just going to focus on money generation on our side. So we're just going to keep eco, and we got our rubber gold up, so we're going to make some solid money from their eco as well. I probably should use the Benjamin ability with the Spike Factory here. Increase its production a little bit. Now, the next rush I want to send, I'm not exactly sure, maybe a Fortified Moab. Fortified BFB is normally a good rush against their loadout as well, so I'll definitely eye that. They're down one boost right now. Their boost count doesn't really matter too much to me. I just want to force defense. Round 17, I don't think a normal mob's very good. A normal mob only forces a Mauler on their side. A Fortified Mob could force an Assassin. And if they don't get their Assassin early, they need to get more defense as well. So we'll see. Second Merchant. Perfect. We'll send them a Fortified Mob in a second. There we go. They sell both their farms for it. And they boost. This is not good at all, dude. That's not the way to defend a Fortified Moab. I guess they just couldn't afford their Assassin there pretty easily, huh? We'll balloon boost this one. Okay, they do that. That should defend. I honestly could have ult-outed them there and probably killed them, but I don't know. There might have been some tech they could have used to defend it. And I'm in such a good position here that I kind of think I'm just safer to take it late. We got a second rubber gold on our end, but we're in a really good spot. I'm going to send them a Fortified BFB now as well. This was a rush I definitely want to send. Especially because they sold all their defense. They sold their Mob Assassin, so like, yeah, this is a good rush. Looks like they're preparing to get up a Moa, what's it called? A Balloon Impact in the back. They have one boost left, if I remember correctly. Does that even stun all the ceramics? Are they dead here? I think they're dead. Yeah, they're dead. Okay. That guy, they definitely aren't the best bomb sub farm player. No doubt, but we did send some good rushes nonetheless. All right, guys, our last match of today's video is going to be an aggressive one because we're on Darling Elk Farm, which is an aggressive strategy here. We're against Salty, starting with their Dart Monkey, actually. So they might be going aggressive strategy as well because Dart Monkey is normally aggro too. This will be an interesting one. I think they brought Star Captain Jericho here, if I remember correctly. So Star Captain Jericho versus Highwayman. It's going to be a fun one. Let's just target my Dartling a little bit here against these balloons, and we'll see if we can get my Highwayman round one. We'll see. I might be able to. I might not be able to. Oh, we got it. They got their Star Captain round one as well. Fair enough. And then, yeah. Just target my Dartling here. Try to leak as minimally as possible. Should I send them Space Greens? I don't know if Space Greens do anything against that Trip Dart. They might. I think they just bought the more Pierce on it, though. I think, yeah, they're good. So we should probably just send Group Reds then. If they're good against the Space Greens, Group Reds are going to be the best send here against the Trip Dart that they've got on their end. It's all good. And then we're going to get faster barrel spin here. Perfect. All right. Everything's chilling so far. Maintaining a healthy life count is going to be important for me so I can leak later without a worry. So we're going to try to accomplish that on my end. And we'll send them space pinks on the next round. They'll get their steel in the next round too. So we'll have to be wary of that. They will get their steel available. Send them some pinks. They go for a crossbow as well on their end. Oh my gosh, they built up so much defense already. They've got a crossbow and a trip dart. Wow. Okay. I guess that works. Just surprised. Okay, they're stealing from me. So what I actually want to do against the steel is I want to avoid some of it. You see how they sent some red balloons with the steel? That's very usual. That's very normal because you need to send a set of red balloons to get the max steel. However, you can actually avoid the red balloons with the steel when you have Dartling here. And I'll do it by targeting my Dartling. Watch this. Target my Dartling around. Don't pop those red balloons. And those balloons just leak and I don't get those. That money does not get stolen from me. It's a 200 IQ tech you can do against Star Captain Jericho when you have Dartling in your loadout. I leak a little bit of lives, but avoiding those couple red balloons are like $100, not $100, maybe like $75 of the steel. It's a good portion of it. $50 of the steel, maybe. But it's definitely worth. Okay, they've got both there. They actually changed their trip dart spot. Yeah, I don't really know what my opponent's cooking. They sold and rebought their trip dart, which is certainly interesting there. Black balloons should not really be a problem for me. I'm just going to save up for another farm here. It might be dart, mortar, boat. That is a loadout I have seen on this map a little bit. Dart, mortar, boat. So that could be what they're cooking here. Okay, I'm not going to avoid those red balloons, unfortunately. We did avoid some of the first set, but that time, it's not really avoidable. They got their merchantman up. I think they got their merchantman up after the round started, so I don't think they got the $300 from that, which is good for me. All right, we're just going to keep on... I should probably boost this, huh? Yeah, that was dumb. I placed another dartling trying to defend it without boost, but in reality, I still need to boost it anyways, so the second dartling was kind of just a waste of money that I put on the field. That was not very... That was not played very well from me. I'll be honest. I did not need to place the second dartling and boost. I would have just been better just boosting straight up. Straight up. Yep, it is mortar. Okay. Dart, mortar, farm. With boat. Alright. Oh, not dart, mortar, farm, boat. Dart, boat, farm. Dart. Dart, mortar, boat. Okay. Dart, mortar, boat. Are they going to send me zebras? The moment doesn't look like it. Let's go for a third farm. Okay, they're stealing again from me. That's fine. We're going to use our second steal in round 11 is going to be the plan. They're probably going to send me leads here. I'm going to upgrade my alchemist against them. No leads. There they are. Okay, we missed a lead. Oh, my alchemist is actually throwing really badly. Alchemist hit leads challenge. Impossible edition. Yeah, my alchemist just kind of completely missed some of those leads. That was kind of actually really unfortunate. Okay, I've definitely got to pressure them here, though. Their loadout does out late game mine, but we should outmoney them with our loadout. So the way we can win this is by sending good pressure rushes. So I'm gonna go for a plantation first and cross path it, but then I'll definitely rush them. Oh, they're rushing me here. Okay, it's gonna alt buff here. Let's get that up. Should be good against that rush. Yep. They did not even need that alchemist, to be honest. Okay, it's time to rush them now. Okay, we forced mortar trifecta on their side and juggernaut. That's good. They have a lot of defense now. I'm not going to re-rush that. That is pretty aptitude defense on their end. We're going to get to like 1k eco, and then I'm a full stop my eco. Our plan is just to be sending... Okay, they're sending me another rush. We're good. Don't even know if I needed Alk buff there, to be honest. We might have actually been able to defend that without Alk buff if I... But I just got up to be safe. Let's get the marketplace here. Let's get to the 1k eco mark. Actually, I should send the Moabs. They are really weak against Moabs currently. Extremely weak. I'm gonna sell my Alk buff. We're gonna balloon boost. Okay, we forced tower boost on there, and that's great. They should be good with tower boost. Oh, they almost died. They actually did not build sharpshooter, which I was expecting them to get. So that's why. Okay, let's send them fortified Moab. Probably gonna go artillery battery. I think they have to artillery battery ability this for sure. They have to use ability. Okay, they use ability. After ability is done, I'm gonna send them another fortified Moab. I placed that farm really poorly too. Balloon boost. Force two sharpshooters on their end. Yeah, this is great. The amount of defense we force on their end with the rushes. Also, I forgot to get lead to gold for this round, but that's fine. I forgot about lead to gold. But this is great. I've definitely sent some smart rushes at them and forced good defense, I think. Okay, we're fine. Almost died against AI, but we're good. Let's just misdirect this. I'm gonna boost against AI here. Got up an IMF loan on my side. Alright. They're starshipping something at me. Okay. I should be fine against this, with boost and everything. Let's boost. Let's use you. We'll balloon boost at them. Okay, we're good. We're gonna keep sending. If they have their darts on strong targeting, the strong targeting is going to hit the fortified ZOMG at the end, which is the plan with it. Okay, keep sending. There's no way to defend. There's no way to defend, right? Oh, their mortar targeting is also terrible. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, dude. I played that game really well, I think. I sent some really smart rushes and defended their rushes decently. Yeah. That's how you do it. That's how you pressure in battles too, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and if you did, please drop a like button on the video, guys. It helps it out for the YouTube algorithm. Also, subscribe. We're trying to hit 50,000 subscribers before the summertime, so if you can help me out there, I'd really appreciate it. But that's it for today. Ramalik out. Peace, lads.